Hi, I'm Emily from the Whale Interpretive Center, and today we're going to be discussing the odontocetes, or the toothed whales. If you'd like to hear this video en français, check out my coworker Audrey's video. She'll be doing the same video for us in French. So the odontocetes, the toothed whales, are a very varied group of individuals, from huge sperm whales to small dolphins and porpoises. These animals come in a lot of different shapes and sizes, and so we're just going to kind of be talking about the unifying characteristics that we see across the group. So, first of all, of course, they all have teeth. So this actually, you know, means a lot because it means that they're eating lots of different prey. The mammal-eating killer whales that we have here are eating seals and sea lions, or, you know, the salmon-eating killer whales are eating salmon. Things like sperm whales are eating squid. And so we get a huge variety, unlike the baleen whales where they're eating really small things. These guys can eat a whole bunch of different stuff. Keeping in mind, of course, that whales don't chew. If it's a big food item, they grab and tear a piece and swallow that piece whole, or they swallow whole if the animal is small enough. So they're not actually chewing like we would. Another thing to keep in mind with these guys is that they also have echolocation. So if you're an odontocete, you are able to echolocate. We did a separate video on this, you can check that out. And it's, you know, this is a fantastic adaptation to help these animals navigate and forage for food. Another thing that these guys have in common is that they are very vocal generally across the board. And they generally have high frequency vocalizations. Think of, you know, that classic dolphin noise, or if you've been to the Whale Interpretive Center, we've played those killer whale vocalizations for you. You know, these are generally a more high pitched noise than you would see on those mysticetes or the baleen whales. Another thing to keep in mind about these guys is they're often very social. Think of those classic killer whales, or other species of dolphins, you know, even sperm whales are generally found in groups. And so they're more social, they're generally more cooperative hunters because they're more social. And that makes sense too, right? Because, I mean, imagine if you're a mammal-eating killer whale trying to take down a speller sea lion, which is also a big creature, you're going to want to be in a group to be able to try and take that animal down. Another thing to think about these guys is that they're usually smaller than the baleen whales. Think of all those dolphins and porpoises, you know, are substantially smaller than something like a fin whale or a blue whale or a humpback whale that has baleen. And so as a result, we end up knowing a little bit more about them generally, because we're able to keep them in captivity, which is, of course, not a great place if you are a marine mammal to be in a tank somewhere. But it does, we're able to learn a lot from that, for about the wild population and about their intelligence and behaviors and that kind of thing. So very social animals on the whole, and that has a lot of ramifications. And also, if you're looking at kind of like, we have one in the museum, or if you maybe have one at home, the poster of all the different types of cetaceans, dolphins, whales, and porpoises, the odontocetes, the toothed animals, they are the majority. The mysticetes or baleen whales are the minority in these guys. So we do have more types of odontocetes than mysticetes. If you'd like to learn more about the odontocetes or the mysticetes, drop by the Whale Interpretive Center in Telegraph Cove.